Here we have a little galaxy far, far away where the sky is white and the stars are black. Stars emit dark rather than light, just because that's the way this universe works, and we're having a space battle between the Schaeferian fine-dibbed race of whatever these people are, and they have rockets that are sort of shaped like this. They sort of look like a plucked chicken. A design. It looks like a plucked chicken, so there are the wings and there are the legs, and the propulsion system comes out of the legs. How about that for our weird universe here? And they're going to be battling the pens from the Venusian world. Venus pen. So this one, this rocket, as you can see, is very, very fine, fine-nibbed, and it has a range that's kind of fun, but this star is going to turn out to be some other kind of propulsion. This is impulse power. This is main thrusters and impulse power. There we go. So two different kinds of power in this battleship, battle thing. And what are the Venusians going to look like? Here's the Venus pen. And it has a very broader nib. What is its battle wagons going to look like? These are the guns. We'll start with the guns. They shoot first and ask questions later. They just have a huge slinky-like spring. They bounce from their planet out into space. So that's what this is. That's the spring. And then they escape the gravity of their planetoid and eventually figure out a way to, maybe they wait until they hit something else and bounce back. But that's how that system works. The spring system versus the whatever propulsion system they have. So here we have another. That's what's sort of fun about deciding in your infinite universes that they say are out there, that anything is possible. In one infinite universe, I am extremely handsome and well-built. And in another universe, I am even more handsome instead of what I am now. So anyway, here are the guns of this second Venusian craft that's bouncing along here. So I don't want the Schaeferians to feel out of place, so I have to get them and give them another rocket based on the carcass of a plucked chicken. I don't know who's going to win this little battle, but it's sort of, this is another example of a pen telling me what to draw. They often do that. It's not just because I'm easily impressionable, which I am. but it's because the pens tell me what to do. I can't help it. They say, okay, you're going to draw this way now, because the pen can draw that way. It's very simple. Oh, I forgot the other propulsion system here, the little pellets. So far, we have the Venusians and the Schaeferians with, I don't know who's going to win yet. What do you think? We'll add another, let's pick another pen from another world. Here is a Waterman pen that has a slightly italic stub nib kind of a thing. So what is their rocket gonna look like? This is gonna look like this. It's gonna be, I watched a video last night about black letter, and black letter is something that I enjoyed doing when I was a kid, and once I discovered flexible nibs, I didn't need to do that anymore. So this black letter has, this is what its propulsion looks like. And this is what its ship looks like. It's made of thick lines and thin lines that are based more on the shape of the nib than the pressure that I apply. So if this is what their propulsion looks like, what are its guns going to look like? They're going to shoot little diamonds out of their little nozzles. Oh, we'll add another one of theirs over here. There, it's again, this pen wants me to make these lines that are, a nib like this, a stub nib, or some people call them italic nibs, broad nibs. Oops, I'm forgetting how the propulsion works here. Is it's sort of these drive me in a certain way, more than a nib that's more rounded. These sort of make me want to go in a certain direction. It's like having a keel on a boat. It really pushes you in a certain direction, and that's what this one does. So anyway, we've got this battle between three completely different spaceships, and I'm not sure who's gonna win, but something's gonna happen. I don't know what though. Shall we add yet another one in? Let's pick a little Schaefer. Another little Schaefer. This is a very fine-nibbed Schaefer. This is related to the other Schaefers here. They're an ally. They've stolen the technology of the, they were sold the technology from the Schaeferians on their planet. And these are related to the Schaeferians. But this particular planet, with their trade with the Schaefers, this particular planet stole the slinky approach to propulsion from the Venusians. Here we go. We'll add one sneaking up here from behind. This is a little spy. Little scout. It doesn't have any guns, unfortunately. So it's no defenses on this one. It's just there to radio back. There's a big radio dish right here. So here's the radio waves. As you see, it doesn't have any wings. It has legs with slinkies on them, but it does not have any little wings. So it's not a very good. Neither does this one either. That has guns. Well, I don't know what's going to happen, but something. That's the Schaefer pen that did the red ones. This is the Venus pen that did the Venusians. This is the Waterman pen that did the sort of black letter. And finally, here's the green Schaefer that did the very fine nibbed ones. Blue ones for the Schaefer. This pen for the red ones. This for the Venus. Let's just do this. Here we go. Ta-da! The inch closer. What's gonna happen? You tell me, folks. Who will win? I'll take a vote and then I'll draw the picture of the winning one. So who do you want to win?